In the previous chapter, we learned about DNA and how it encodes information. We will now explain how traits are inherited from one generation to the next in sexually reproducing organisms. The laws of inheritance were discovered by the Slovakian monk Gregor Mendel, whom I consider to be the greatest biologist of all times. Mendel established a highly successful experimental system and managed to decipher the rules of inheritance by himself while working in complete isolation. He was so much so ahead of his time that after his death his work was forgotten for 30 years, a time during which others tried in vain to understand how heredity works, until the rediscovery of his paper.
Sexual reproduction is a procedure by which two cells fuse to form one new cell. Each of the original cells contained the entire required genetic information. In humans, for example, 23 chromosomes. The new cell contains thus two different copies of this information. In humans, 46 chromosomes. The one copy state is called haploid and the two copy state diploid. These are highly important terms and will serve us extensively throughout the course, and it is important to understand and remember them. In most multicellular organisms, the main stage is diploid. For example, each cell of our body is diploid and has two copies of the genome, one from our father and the second from our mother. In order to reproduce, we have to make haploid gametes by a special process called meiosis, that is the basis of all sex, and we will describe in detail in the next chapter.
At this stage, it is sufficient to know that each organism has two copies of the genome. Using this basic knowledge, we will explain laws of genetics that Mendel discovered. The two copies of each diploid individual are very similar. However, in most cases, they are not identical. The variability of the population is due to these differences. The two copies of each gene are called alleles. In the diploid genome, there are two alleles of each gene. These alleles can either be identical or different. Each individual transfers to each of its offspring only one allele. The second allele this offspring gets from its other parent. In the entire population, there exist one, two, or many different alleles for each gene.
For example, in the flowers Mendel used, the gene that determines the color of the flowers has two different alleles, a purple allele and a white allele. When Mendel mates a purple flower that had two purple alleles with a white one that had two white alleles, he got only purple flowers. Let me explain why. As you can see in this table, each of the plants transferred to its offspring only one allele. The purple flower had only purple alleles, and the white one only white alleles. It is thus obvious that all offspring inherited one purple and one white allele. As you can see, different alleles can have different effects. There are alleles that are dominant, like the purple one, and alleles that are recessive, like the white one. It is sufficient that all plants will carry a single purple allele to have purple flowers. What do you think will happen if we will mate two purple plants that each carry one purple and one white allele? Remember that each offspring gets one allele from each of its parents. In this table we can see that a quarter of the offspring will inherit two white alleles, and they will be white. A quarter of the offspring will inherit two purple alleles, and they will be purple. The rest of the offspring inherit one white and one purple allele, and they will be purple like their parents. This is the foundation of Mendel's rule of inheritance, and if we understand it all, the rest becomes straightforward. There are, for example, many human genetic diseases that are caused by recessive allele. When both parents carry one such allele, they are not affected because they have also a dominant healthy allele. But the baby will be affected if he inherits the recessive allele from both parents. Let us calculate the probability that this will happen. The probability that the father will contribute the sick allele is 50%. And the probability that the mother will contribute it is also 50%. The product of these probabilities is 25%, and this is the probability that the baby will be affected by the disease. Not all recessive traits are diseases, and not all genetic diseases are caused by recessive alleles. The relationship between alleles is not always dominant or negative. Sometimes, two alleles have a similar degree of influence. Human blood types are a good example. There exist two dominant alleles, A and B, and one recessive allele called O. An individual that has A and B alleles will have blood type AB. An individual that has two O alleles will have blood type O. An individual that has two A alleles, or A and O, will have blood type A. An individual that has two B alleles, or B and O, will have blood type B. Many traits are established by interaction between multiple genes. For example, how tall we are. It is much more difficult to decipher the inheritance of such multiple gene traits. We are aware of the fact that this video is a bit complex for those of you who haven't studied biology, and a bit simplistic for those of you who have. This information is, however, both useful and sufficient for the rest of the course.